We've now learned how to pull data out of a table, and at this point, it looks like we just used SQL to pull raw information out of our database. In other words, we stored this exact set of information, these exact columns right here, and it appears that we can just pull exactly those columns out. But it turns out that when we are making use of SQL, we can actually somehow transform or process data before we pull it out of the database. Let me show you what I mean. So if we think about our cities table right now, you'll recall that we have population and area in here as columns. There might be a really useful metric that we could try to calculate for all these different cities. Maybe we could try to find the population density of each city, which would be defined as each city's population divided by its area. That would give us the population density, the number of people per square kilometer in this city. So we would want to calculate that value for each individual row. To do so, we would eventually end up with something that looks like this right here. We would take Tokyo's 38 million and divide it by 8223. We would take Delhi's 28 million and divide it by 2240, and so on. This is a calculation that we would want to repeat for every single row inside of our table. Let's figure out how to write a little bit of SQL that will automatically do this calculation for us for each individual row. Okay, so back over here, I'm going to delete the star that I had previously, and then I'll print out each individual city's name, and then after that, I'm going to calculate each city's population divided by its area. So in this case, we are doing a calculation right here. You can imagine that we are kind of making an imaginary column inside the database, kind of like a temporary calculated column. If we now run this query, we'll see that we get the name of each city and then the population density right next to it. So this is the number of people per square kilometer in that city. We are not limited to just using division operators. We can also use many other math operators, such as addition, subtraction, multiplication. We can find the exponent between two columns, square, root, absolute value, remainder, and so on. There are even more math operators than what you see right here, but these are some of the ones you're going to use most frequently. And even out of these, you'll most frequently just use the ones on the left-hand side. So for example, if we wanted to find, for some crazy reason, it doesn't really make a lot of sense, but maybe the population plus the area. We could put in population plus area like so. All right, looks like we get a large number there that looks more or less accurate. We could multiply the two. And if we do so, we end up getting an error here because remember, an integer value inside of Postgres can only go up to about 2.14 billion. In this case, if we try to multiply the population by the area, we get an integer value that is too large. And that's why we see an error here of integer out of range. But regardless, we can imagine that yes, we can multiply two columns by each other. So I'm going to take this back to population divided by area and run it again. The last thing I want to mention here is that you'll notice that the result that we get right here has a name of question mark column question mark. The reason for that is that Postgres understands that we are doing a calculation right here, but it doesn't really know what to call the result. It's not going to call it for us automatically something like population divided by area, so it just gives us kind of this temporary name right here of question mark column question mark. That's not a very helpful column name because it doesn't really tell you and I what the values in here are really all about. So what we can do to make this a little bit more clear just for you and I is rename this calculated column. To rename a column, I'm going to put a new line right there, and then right after the calculation of population divided by area, I will write in as and then population underscore density. So that will calculate a new value and then name this new temporary calculated column as population underscore density. Now, if I run that, I get a column name that makes a lot more sense. And it's a lot more clear about what all these different values are really trying to tell us. We do not have to call this population density. We could call this column anything we want. So it could be just density by itself. Now we get a column named density. Okay, so that's a little bit on math operators and how we rename a calculated column as well.